Oops, she did it again. White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders fired off a bizarre tweet shortly before the swearing-in ceremony of CIA Director Gina Haspel today. Rather than welcoming the appointment as a win for our intelligence community, which is in need of quality leadership, Sanders hailed it as a victory in the war against women, women in the Trump administration. Sanders tweeted, "Historic day for our country, swearing-in ceremony for Gina Haspel, the first woman ever to serve as CIA director. Democrats are losing their war against women in the Trump administration." First things first, there is no Democratic war on Trump women. Every Democrat I've talked to feels sorry for women in the Trump White House. That's in part because women like Sarah Sanders are failing to protect women in Trump's White House. In defending men like Rob Porter, they have made the White House unsafe for women. Of course, this isn't the first time that Sarah Sanders has drawn from this well. Just 2 weeks ago, I sat at this very desk and railed against her for committing the same offense when, ahead of Haspel's Senate confirmation hearing, Sanders tweeted, "There is no one more qualified to be the first woman to lead the CIA than 30-plus year CIA veteran Gina Haspel. Any Democrat who claims to support women's empowerment and our national security but opposes her nomination is a total hypocrite." Now, that one was wrong for a number of reasons. First of all, if Gina Haspel is the most qualified person for the job, then why did Sarah make it about women at all? It undercuts the whole argument. Second, supporting women's empowerment doesn't mean you have to support every policy or position a woman takes just because she has a uterus. Finally, none of that is hypocritical. Actually, for a Democrat who claims to support women's empowerment to nonetheless oppose Haspel, a woman, is at worst partisan, but at best principled. Okay, here's the deal. I am sick of this. Of all the things that this White House has done to offend the conservative heart and mind, this particularly offends mine. Pitting women against each other, pitting our identities against our ideologies, and playing the woman card just because you have one is not conservative. This is explicitly the kind of thing we conservatives have spent decades railing against the left for. Since the invention of identity politics, it has been the conservative stake in the ground that is bad. It's bad for the people it's meant to help. It's bad for politics in general, and it's bad for the nation. Yes, it's also bad for women. So it's particularly bad now coming from a Republican administration and a woman in a top position in an official capacity. This kind of weaponizing of identity politics that Sarah seems to love to engage in is just odious and generally awful. So stop doing it. Stop doing it right now. Okay, let me bring in my guest, former New York City Council Speaker and CEO of Women in Need, Christine Quinn. Christine, you and I can disagree on all kinds of policy issues.
Yes.
I have a feeling Sarah Sanders, though, is about to make us strange bedfellows.
Absolutely.
Let me ask you, is there a Democratic war on women? Did someone send a memo or
And if they had, I would have gotten it. Trust me,
I'm
I
sure.
would have gotten it. No, there is no Democratic war against Trump. Women, none. I mean, it's just ridiculous. It's completely fabricated, A. And B, if Sarah needed to fabricate something, because we know she's not above that.
Yep.
Why this?
It is weird. If anything, I mean, she in particular should know Democrats were defending her
right.
against
right.
some criticism that she got at the White House Correspondents' Dinner. If anything, I hear Democrats supportive of women in Trump's
Absolutely.
White House because they generally feel like they're hostages.
No, I have not heard any rhetoric against women serving in a Trump White House. I've not heard that at all. It doesn't
it's
exist.
Bizarre.
And I don't know why, given the person she works for, who has an incredibly, and I'm being generous, spotty background
yes.
as it relates to
yes.
women and women's issue, why you would strategically
walk
into this. Because
right.
it just screams hypocrisy.
Yes.
And it's a message to us on the left to re-bring up all the sexual assault and all of those issues
sure.
that came out during the campaign.
Sure.
It makes me think Sarah Sanders is far more desperate and mm-hmm. far deeper in her drowning than mm-hmm. I ever realized.
Interesting. Well, I supported Gina Haspel's nomination. I think she's eminently qualified. But if you didn't, is that sexism?
But I didn't support it. I have tremendous
right.
concerns over the torture issues, right?
That's fair.
But that doesn't make me an anti-feminist. It doesn't make me a woman hater. It doesn't make me a hypocrite. I think to say, look, I believe we need more women elected officials. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't mean everybody who has a uterus has to support every other person who has a uterus. There's a question of qualifications, of principles,
yes,
of positions. And why should just erase that when there was no... It's not like the Democratic senators or congresswomen stood up and said, I'm, as women... We're not endorsing her because of the torture.
I heard no one, no Democrat, and there were some Republicans who had some issues with Gina Haspel as well. I didn't hear the fact that she was a woman raised once. And in fact, I think it's doing the disservice to Gina Haspel,
right,
whose record should stand on its own. She was confirmed today. Why do you keep picking this fight? But now you're drawing attention to the fact that she's a woman. Shouldn't it just be that she was the most qualified person for the job?
I agree with you. Now, look, I would, if I was Sarah Sanders, I would have at the end of a statement or whatever said, and we're excited that we've now broken a barrier in the CIA.
Sure.
You should be noted.
Sure.
But this kind of contorting it to say it was Republicans who rose above, also to make it sound like it was a complete down party line vote, which it was not.
Right.
That's a fact. However you're looking at it, they're just untrue, made up things. In addition to going, why, you want to go, Sarah, a lot of Americans think your boss lies.
Yes.
That you make up stuff for him and keep spinning it and spreading it.
Yeah.
Why do it again here when you get nothing out of it?
No, I agree. It also just makes me, it makes me really angry because, and I got this all the time for not supporting Hillary Clinton. I'm a traitor to my gender. How as a woman could I not support Hillary Clinton? And I didn't not support her because of her uterus.
Right.
I did not support her for lots of other reasons.
You have different policy perspectives.
Of course I do. But there were also Democrats did not support her they voted for President Obama.
If you had supported Hillary Clinton because she was a woman, I would have said, like, Essie, what
Where
happened?
Are your principles?
Right. Did you fall and hit your head? Like, what happened?
No offense. Have you been speaking to Sarah Sanders? Because this is... This is ripped out of the liberal playbook. You know this.
100%.
Conservatives have long railed against identity politics, doing exactly what Sarah is doing right now. And you know, Sarah Sanders is no newcomer to Republican politics.
No. Right.
It's in her bloodstream. Right. That's why it makes me think.
Before. She must have seen my team level this against people. It can't be news to her.
No, and if I could tell you how many times, Christine, I have been in a room with Kellyanne Conway before she went into the White House, telling a group of girls about this exact thing. Don't do this thing. Don't do this thing. It's just crazy to me that this White House, these particular people are picking up this liberal identity politics thing, this weaponizing our gender.
And it feels to me like, but I could be totally wrong, that it's from her, because this doesn't sound like an instruction you would get from Donald Trump.
No. I mean, you could see him say, this is great, we got a woman at
yes,
CIA,
totally.
Make a big deal about
yes.
it. But to declare a Democratic war on women that is non-existent, that is happening nowhere, and just drawing attention to the fact that Gina Haspel is a woman, it's just a really bad look
Right,
for
and
women.
Look, the message for the White House, and I don't want to help them, but is, you know, that Pompeo got in, that Haspel got in, those are two big, and one could argue controversial, appointments that they got through.
Right.
They should be doing a victory lap around that, not this issue of gender and making up more stories about the Democrats.
No, it doesn't make any sense, and I hope it stops.